Welcome to the Center for Spiritual Living in Southeast Louisiana. I'm Reverend Larrye-Marie Heyl, the Spiritual Director here. We are a group of radically inclusive spiritual renegades, healing hearts and creating community. And each of us embrace conscious spiritual living. Today we're taking a break from our Five Agreements series to honor mothers. Our service is about the architecture of a mother's love and the varying ways in which each of us receive love from our earthly mothers or for people who stepped up to fill in for our earthly mothers. It's also about the divine feminine, which nurtures and grows anything in its embrace. So stay with us today as we examine how to be grateful to our mothers, whether they did a great job or a horrid one, and how to nurture that within us that creates and heals through receiving love. Let's pray. So we connect with that divine feminine that is part of the essence of the divine. That feminine nature of unconditional love, of creativity and nurturing. And we know that all that that is lives right within us. And it's indeed the blueprint of our soul. What I know is that we are each here by divine appointment to hear something today, perhaps to heal something that's been waiting to be healed. It might be from the message or from the music, from the reading, from a particular song that touched our hearts, or a particular quote that just struck in that way of us knowing that it's the absolute truth. Whether it be from one or many of those ways, what I know is that each of us today is expanding our spiritual territory by joining in and listening to this message. And I'm grateful for that. I'm grateful to know that the God without lives within me and within everyone watching this message and everyone on this planet. I'm grateful to know that the essence of our being is love. And it's from that gratitude that I release these words into the law of mind, spirit, and action, knowing the truth that the answer has already been said, and it is a definite yes. So I can just let it be. I say amen, and we can affirm it together. And so it is. And I hope that you'll join in and sing the words and the music of Daniel Namod, whose song, Love is My Decision, is all about our message today. Sing along. Right here and now. So this is our time for celebration and healing. Our time in our service where we celebrate life and we pray for people who desire prayer. We begin with celebration, so I invite you to say aloud so that the whole universe can hear it, any event in your life for which you're grateful and joyful this week. And now we turn to the healing portion of our service. We're a community steeped in healing. So we pause now to pray for anyone who's not feeling the joy of life that we perhaps were just feeling. They're not feeling maybe that they have things to celebrate. And I truly love this part of our service because it's so in alignment with who we are. So let's pray. God is all there is. God is that love and that peace and ease and grace and freedom and so much more. And as an individual expression of the divine, each of us have within us all of these qualities of spirit. They're available to us right here and right now. And what I know to be the truth is that there are people on this planet right now that aren't embracing those qualities. So we stop for a moment and we create a circle of love. And in this community, we place in that circle of love anyone that we recognize within ourselves or for someone else that might need prayer. So I'm going to pause and I just invite you to say aloud the names of all of those people that you want to include in our circle of love. I know that God is right where each of us happens to be, right here and right now, moving in through and as each of us. And I know that the divine has heard every name that we spoke, either in our hearts or aloud. And what I'd like you to do now is pause again, and from your heart to all of theirs, just send out love, knowing that the divine knows exactly how to distribute it. And what I know to be the truth is that anything that needs to be released within each of these people is being released now, be it disease of the mind, of the body, of the soul. I know that anything that's seeking to come forth and be lifted up can be lifted up. And that this release and this lifting up is healing whatever's called to be healed. I know that each of these people is feeling more deeply their connection with the divine right now. I have evidence of that, and I know it to be the truth for everyone that we place in our circle. So I'm so grateful to know that the God without is the God within me. The God without is the God within every person in our circle, every person in this community, and every person on this planet. And I'm grateful for that power of community prayer and what it means to the uplifting of the people on this planet. So it's from all that gratitude that I release this prayer into the law of mind, spirit, and action. Because I know that the divine, in all of its wisdom, has already called all of this good. Any heavy lifting that needs to be done to heal whatever needs to be healed, the divine has already taken care of. So I can just know it's already done, say amen, and together we can affirm it. And so it is. I invite you to join me for our community affirmation. My life's purpose is already within me, and I am committed to its unfoldment. I am here by divine appointment to join in a community that cares for one another, to be in a place that transforms people's lives, to remember the highest truth about myself, to learn spiritual tools for personal transformation, and thus to make the world a more joyful place. So this is our time for meditation. I just invite you to let go of anything that's brought you to this moment, anything from the past. Release any thoughts of the future. and just settle into this moment right here and right now where you can have some private time with the divine. Our song today is Listen to My Heart's Song. Take a deep, nourishing breath, and we settle into that place where we can truly listen to our heart's song. That place within us that knows only love, that knows that when we quiet our mind, we can hear the voice of Spirit. So let us relax in the arms of the divine and allow ourselves to be nurtured and loved. And allow any healing that we seek to occur right here and now. And as we return from our time with the divine, let us just bask in that feeling of having been nurtured and loved. Let us release anything that needs releasing and return to this time fully relaxed and feeling loved.
Listen to my heart's song. Listen to My name is Gloria Nye. I'm the mother of two daughters, Maureen and Jaffe, two sons, Don and Paul, grandmother of eight grandchildren, Lauren, Nick, Brian, Bobby, Abigail, Tanner, Ava, and Noah, and great-grandmother of four great-grandchildren, Troy, Amina, Cassius, and Grayson. Today's reading is an excerpt from John O'Donohue's book, Beauty, The Invisible Embrace. The reading is entitled, Where Love Has Lived. A home is not simply a building. It is the shelter around the intimacy of a life. Coming in from the outside world and its rasp of force and usage, you relax and allow yourself to be who you are. The inner walls of a home are threaded with the textures of one's soul, a subtle weave of presences. If you could see your home through the lens of the soul, you would be surprised at the beauty concealed in the memory your home holds. When you enter some homes, you sense how the memories have seeped to the surface, infusing the aura of the place and deepening the tone of its presence. Where love has lived, a house still holds the warmth. Even the poorest home feels like a nest if love and tenderness dwell there.
This song before the message says it all. There's only love. Everything else is a choice to separate ourselves from that one life that's God's life and that's our life and the life of everyone on this planet. So I invite you to sing along and remember, love sets us free and there is only love.
All that heals, all that sets us free.
I'd like to thank Gloria Nye for reading today. And I can say that her home is a nest because love and tenderness definitely abide there. She's a great mom and grandmother. I also want to thank our music team, and especially Katrina Smith for her lovely solo. It's a beautiful song, and you'll be privileged to hear it later in the service. Today is Mother's Day, a day in which we celebrate mothers. So happy Mother's Day to every mother, adopted mother, wannabe mother, those living in a male body, to everyone who mothered expertly, and to those who failed miserably. It's a blessed role and a complicated one, and it brings love and joy, pain and suffering. It's not for the faint of heart. Whether you've given birth or adopted, choosing to love and care for a life is a choice of the highest order, the most sacred, and a choice that lasts a lifetime. May you feel blessed, loved, and appreciated on this day, even if your children do not know how to express it. You have been ordained by the Beloved because you said yes to this role in whatever form, and it is indeed a blessing. I also want to recognize that Mother's Day can be a bit of a mixed bag for some people. So while we take time today to honor mothers and acknowledge the power of our earthly mother's love, I'm very sensitive to those who never felt it. So our topic for today's message is the architect of a mother's love. But first, the question of the week. What is the one choice you can make today to fully embrace the nurturing of a mother's love and to use your own love to nurture, to create, and to heal? One more time. What is the one choice you can make today to fully embrace the nurturing of a mother's love and to use your own love to nurture, to create, and to heal? If you've traveled the world or watched movies or TV, you must be aware that the architecture around the world varies widely. From the Eiffel Tower in Paris, the Guggenheim Museum in New York, the Taj Mahal in India, the pyramids in Egypt, the Dancing House in Prague, the Acropolis in Athens, Westminster Abbey in London, the Colosseum in Rome, Casa Mila in Barcelona, Hagia Sophia in Istanbul, the Lotus Temple in New Delhi, Angkor Wat in Cambodia, the Sistine Chapel in the Vatican City, the Sydney Opera House in Australia, and the White House in our very own capital. And let's not forget the Leaning Tower of Pisa in Italy. I think you would agree that the many styles of architecture show us that there is not only one way to create and build a structure of beauty. The process varies and is dependent on many factors, one of which is the foundation, and another the creativity of the designer. And yet other factors include location, religious inheritance, political influence, and many others. I've had the opportunity to personally visit a lot of what I just showed you, and what I know is that each structure in its own way had its own beauty and struck my heart as lovely. Even the Leaning Tower of Pisa, which I have to admit was quite a sight, it did make me a bit leery until I'd heard that they were shoring up and reinforcing it. You're most likely getting the picture now that when we look at the architecture of a mother's love, there's no simple approach that clearly defines it. There are so many ways for a mother to show love to her children and to create a structure of connection. And some end up like the Leaning Tower of Pisa, not built on a strong foundation and leaning, needing to be supported in different ways, perhaps by other people or by the child as he or she grows up, learning to nurture by self-love. I want to tell you a story this morning, which is a true one, from the book, The Architecture of All Abundance. It was written a number of years ago by Lynedra Carroll, who you might know as the mother of the pop star Jewel. It seems very appropriate to what I want to talk about today. The little girl watched the woman in the church with a new baby. They were right next to her. The baby snuggled in a soft white blanket, dressed up in a beautiful long white gown that was all lace and ribbons. The lady cradled her little one in her arms, beaming down with a beautiful smile, cooing quietly. Her glossy black hair fell across the snowy blanket, touching the baby's cheek lightly. And after a while, the baby began to fuss and squirm. "Shh," the woman croned, rocking the baby carefully. Her eyes were so gentle. "Shh, shh, shh." Her voice was soft and soothing. Rocking, she just continued. "Shh." As the baby quieted, the little girl by their side felt a deep longing. "I want that," she said to herself. "I want someone to hold me just like that." She sat very still for a long time, pretending she was the baby. It felt so safe and warm there, right next to the pretty lady. That sense of being completely enveloped in protection and love in a safe and secure blanket, that feeling of being completely filled with indescribably delicious, unconditional love is something we all crave. Each and every one of us, whether we're a little girl or a grown woman, a little boy or a grown man, it doesn't matter. We crave that unconditional love. Some of us received it as babies and as children, and as adults from our earthly mothers. I was one of those fortunate people. Others, like the author, who was the little girl beside the pretty lady in the story, did not. And for those reasons, to approach what indeed is a mixed bag of conditions about our mother and emotions around motherhood, I want to honor mothers and acknowledge the power of a mother's love while being sensitive to those who never felt it. I plan to begin by recognizing the critically important role that our earthly mothers played in our lives, and then moving to the feminine principle, which is the concept of divine mother love. And finally, I think of tremendous, perhaps greatest importance, we come full circle and connect with the divine mother love that's within each of us. So let's approach this message, remembering the words of Charles Filmore. If we would draw us to love, we must be love. We all owe our mothers a deep and heartfelt thank you. Yes, I said all. Why do I say that? It's pretty simple. Without our mother, we wouldn't be here. As Galinda said in the whimsical musical Wicked, as she began to tell the story of the Wicked Witch of the West, she had a mother, like so many people do. Some school-age children were asked once, why did God make mothers? And the answer included, she's the only one who knows where the scotch tape is. Mostly to clean the house. Think about it. It's the best way to get more people. But the most insightful child said, to help us get out of there when we're getting born. Yes, without our mothers, we would never have been born. So whether you're on the mother continuum on the one end of having been truly nurtured, had a wonderfully loving and caring mother, or on the other end, the wick of the West is your mother, we each owe our mothers a thank you for bringing us into the world. I've said now a couple times that we owe our earthly mothers a thank you. But what if for today we chose to freely give it? What if we chose to freely give a thank you to our mothers, whether they're still with us or not, whether they were wonderful or not so wonderful, and whether they were present in our lives or absent? Could we do that right now? I invite you to just close your eyes just for a moment. And in the silence of your heart, thank your mother for bringing you into this world. And as you continue to keep your eyes closed, consider if just this morning we gave our earthly mothers more than a thank you. What if again, in the silence of our own hearts, we stepped up spiritually, put on our big spiritual shoes, and chose to accept our mother for exactly who she is or was, with all her gifts and her faults, all of her flaws, and celebrated her gifts, forgave her for her flaws, and simply loved her. I recognize this will be easy for some people like me and very difficult for others. But I invite you to do it anyway. I'm reminded of the poem written by Mother Teresa entitled Do It Anyway. And the first line reads, people are often unreasonable, illogical, and self-centered. Love them anyway. So how about if we love our mothers anyway, just for a few moments? Thank you. So as you open your eyes, just take a deep breath and know that you are loved right here and right now. Are you ready to move on? Great. The concept of a mother is so much broader than our experience of our earthly mothers. And we do motherhood and ourselves a grave injustice when we limit our thinking to just our experience of our own mother. For motherhood is, in fact, a spiritual concept, the concept of the feminine principle or the divine mother. Ernest Holmes refers to this feminine principle as the universal womb of nature because it's creative and receptive, and it unconditionally nurtures and grows whatever falls into its embrace. Again, it's creative and receptive, and it unconditionally nurtures and grows whatever falls into its embrace. This is God in the mode of universal mother. And human mother, with all her history, fears, faults, and so on. The nurturing nature of the universe, of that divine mother, is the very essence of unconditional love. An unconditional love that's part of the divine and lives within each of us. The divine mother is always attending to her children in whatever way serves their eternal needs. She gives her children freedom to choose the rocky road of life and to experience all the pain of the path. yet she's always there when they ask for help. And like the mother bird who, when the little baby birds are ready to face the world, pushes them out of the nest, the cosmic mother does the same thing. She allows us to fully experience life on our own terms. But unlike the mother bird, our cosmic mother always allows us to come home to the divine at any moment. It's the cosmic mother's nature. God, as the divine feminine, is unconditional love. The French mystic Pierre Teilhard de Chardin put it this way. The condition is always the same. Love is the most powerful energy in the world. I believe that most all of us would agree with that statement. Unconditional love is the most powerful energy in the world. Buddhism has a wonderful story about the nature of this power. It's the voice of Yin, the feminine wisdom, attributed to the Buddha. And the story goes this way. There was a powerful macho bandit who approached the Buddha and informed him that he was a ferocious bandit, the mightiest in the world, and he was going to kill the Buddha to demonstrate his great power. The Buddha said, "Ah, well, then surely you can first grant me two wishes." The bandit says, "Get on with it." The Buddha points to a small sapling nearby tree and says, "Please cut off the smallest branch on that young tree." The bandit laughed, waved his sword. It was done. "And what's your final wish?" the bandit asked the Buddha. The Buddha held up the small severed branch and said to the bandit, "Now put it back." Legend has it that the bandit achieved enlightenment in that moment. The true meaning of power is to create life, not to destroy it. It's so true that love creates. It does not destroy. In The Science of Mind, Ernest Holmes wrote, "Love is the grandest healing and drawing power on earth. It is the sole impulse for creation." And that love is the love of the cosmic mother. It's the power to create life. Charles Filmore, in his Talks on Truth, wrote, "Pure love is without discriminating power. It simply pours itself out upon the object of its affection and takes no account of the result." And so, my friends, this Mother's Day can be a chance for each of us to consciously connect and reconnect with the principle of the divine feminine within ourselves, which is where the true power of unconditional love, the true power of creation, resides. We can take today to pour pure love upon ourselves, to be the architect of our own lives and the mother of our own soul. Connect with the divine feminine and use that nurturing power to heal any differences you have with your earthly mother and to nurture your own child within, to mother that child within you that still perhaps has a few things that it would like to be nurtured, a few things that that little girl in the pew next to the beautiful lady wished that she could have. Allow forgiveness to set you and your mother free from anything that is not love between you. Let me repeat that. Allow forgiveness to set you and your mother free from anything that is not love between you. One last story. It was in a newspaper in Iowa. And it was titled, Dog Has Kittens for Lunch. You can understand why some of the visitors to this particular shelter were a little freaked out. It's not every day that you see a dog having a kitten for lunch, and not just one kitten, but a whole litter of them. The story of this unusual dining arrangement began when Lily, a mixed lab and who knows what else, was found along an old farm road. She was pregnant and soon had the puppies, and all of them had just been adopted. Everything was normal until one day, a litter of kittens showed up with no mother. A lady at the shelter admitted that they couldn't possibly bottle feed all of these small kittens. Then she came up with a possible solution, and she decided to see if it would work. She brought the kittens to Lily to see if Lily would nurture them, which she did. She had them for lunch, for dinner, and breakfast. Lily nurtured the kittens in other ways as well. When one kitten fell into her water bucket, she rescued the little troublemaker and carried it off to safety. And amazingly, it turns out that Lily is not one of a kind. There's a story about a wildcat who heard an abandoned fawn crying for food, and he took in the little dearlet. There's also a story about a goat who raised a baby horse. Perhaps most amazing of all is a leopard who killed a baboon, unwittingly creating an orphan. Now, the leopard could have had the orphan baby as an appetizer, but instead, it sat down and nurtured it. Why would animals show such grace? The instinct to love and nurture must be deeply wired into all beings. And when you take away outside factors and influence, that's what we do. We nurture, we love, because it's who we are. We are each an image in the likeness of the divine, of the cosmic mother. And whether we're male or female makes no difference. Lynetra Carroll also wrote, "This love in truth simply is. Love is. Love is the essence of the life force surrounding us. It is what allows everything to have cohesion. Love is both our birthright and our legacy. Love is the original blueprint of our soul." I love that. Love is the original blueprint of our soul. Love is what we are. We don't have to search for it or work at it or win it to hold on to it. It's in us and all around us in every other being. We can take refuge in love when we're afraid. We can tap into it to heal our heart. We can send it out to a hurting friend, and we can deepen into it and allow it to be the sole impulse for building our lives. Truly, the architecture of a mother's love is as diverse as each of us, and yet there is that unity of oneness that connects all of us, the essence of which is love, that blueprint of our soul. So today, I invite you to deepen into that love that is the sole impulse for building your life. I invite you to build your life on the solid foundation of the love of the divine, of that cosmic mother, which surrounds you, which is you, and comes from you and comes back to you as you send it out. And so, in summary, decide this week to be the architect of your own life and of all the love that lives within you. Remember, architectures vary, as does the architecture of a mother's love. So be grateful to your mother for your existence. Love and forgive your mother, and let go of expectations that didn't get met, and release any hurt that's still residing in your soul. Allow forgiveness to set you and your mother free. Accept the Divine Mother who nurtures unconditionally. As Pierre Teilhard de Chardin wrote, love is the most powerful energy of the world. Love creates, love nurtures, it heals, it never destroys. So here's your affirmation for the week. How is it I so easily and willingly make the choice today to fully embrace the nurturing of a mother's love and to use my own love to nurture, to create, and to heal? So your challenge for the week is to make a conscious choice to let go of anything that is not love and to use your own love to nurture, create, and heal anything within you or those that you encounter that it's time to release. Remember, as Charles Filmore wrote, if we would draw to us love, we must be love. Let's pray. So in this time of recognizing that divine mother within us, all of that nurturing love that lives within us as unique expressions of the divine, what I know to be the truth is that we are each learning to nurture ourselves, to bring forth anything that needs to be healed so that we can heal it, to create within ourselves a depth of love that is so strong that whenever we see anyone, all we see is love. I am so grateful. I'm so grateful for this opportunity to be in a community that loves one another, that heals one another, that supports one another. And I'm so grateful to know that while the architecture of each of our loves varies so widely, that the essence of all of that architecture is the blueprint of our soul, which is love. So it's with great gratitude that I release these words into the law of mind, spirit, and action, into that divine who always says yes. So knowing that it's already done, I just release it, I let it be. I say amen, and together we affirm it. And so it is. So I want to once again thank everyone that's continuing to support us. On this Mother's Day, I invite you to make a special contribution to the mother of your heart that is your spiritual mother. And whether it be this community or another community, remember that the love that resides within you circulates and comes back to you as you circulate all that is good. Your service, your talents, your tithes. So thank you once again. Enjoy our offertory song.
From the love of your spirit within me, I bless this gift. I sent it forth to heal, bless, and prosper. It does good work in the world and returns to me. Multiply. the love of your Spirit within me, a blessed gift. I send it forth to heal, bless, and prosper. It doesn't work in the world and return.
You can find all of the information for donating at our website at cslsoutheastla.org. You can use the donate button there, or you can use Zelle or Venmo at 225-287-8887. You can text your amount to 1-225-320-5100, or you can mail your donation to CSL Southeast Louisiana, care of Reverend Larrye-Marie Heyl, 445 Magnolia Wood Avenue, Baton Rouge, Louisiana, 70808. We thank you for your tithes and donations, and we appreciate the fact that you are giving gifts that are flowing out to everyone we touch.
I truly want to thank Katrina Smith for this beautiful song, A Mother's Love. She provides us with this beautiful melodic voice and a beautiful message in the words of the song. Pay close attention.
In a mother's love, you will find everything, everything's alright. To a mother's love, you are bound. You can rest on sacred ground. In a mother's love, you are free to dream, because she sees what you can be. In a mother's love, you see the sun enough for two, but for you are one. In a mother's love, you can feel when something hurts. You can heal. Yes, a mother's love is real. Mother's love.
smoking for a life and a mother's love. Never mind.
Go back to our series on the five agreements with the topic, don't take anything personally. Or the way I say it in a slightly more positive way, take everything at face value. Last week, we learned to be loving in our opinions and in our interactions with others. And today, we learn to love unconditionally, to send out that love. Next week, we look at how to handle situations when other people are sharing their thoughts and opinions with us and it doesn't feel very loving. When we learn that their words are just their own reality and not necessarily our truth, we can accept what they say with grace and without taking it personally. I hope you'll decide to join us next week as we continue on our series and talk about that second agreement.
Thank you for joining us today. I invite you to like us on Facebook at Center for Spiritual Living, Southeast Louisiana. And please follow us on our YouTube channel at CSL SELA. And it's just about time to join in our community time, which is a live discussion that follows the service every Sunday at 11:45 a.m. You have a little bit of time to go get a cup of coffee or some tea, and then dial into our conference line. The number is 540-792-0192. And the participation code is 475-220. We hope you'll join us.
So in closing, remember, Disney claims to be the happiest place on earth, but we at the Center for Spiritual Living in Southeast Louisiana absolutely know in the depths of our heart that we are the most joyful. So until we meet again, may you be wrapped in the arms of love and kindness. And may you remember that if we would draw to us love, we must be love. And when we love unconditionally and use our love to nurture, to create, and to heal, what I know is we feel very much alive.
Forevermore, my spirit is alive, alive forevermore.